everybody. I wanted to show you something I have found. I saw this at I think it was at Sadie Saves the Day here on YouTube, but she showed and told us about the Jackson Art webshop, which ships art supplies worldwide, has this material guide book or booklet that you actually get for free with your order. And so I ordered it, and I think this is one of this is just genius. So I have to share this with you guys. This is not a book that shows what Jackson Art sells. It is more okay, it does that as well, but it's not a catalog by everything they have. It is actually like a manual thing. So I will show you. As they say, far from being just on the other art materials catalog, they have made a compendium of features, articles, and reuse that they hope will serve us to both inspire and inform us. And it really does. So this is the content. And it starts out with what paint is best for you. So if you can see it, it learns or tells us a little bit on the quality of oil and colors, oil paints, acrylic paints, watercolors, and pastels. What they are made of, the differences, the pros and the cons with the different mediums. And then we have in depth more about each. So this is a guide to oil paint. What makes it special, how it dries, what is the difference between traditional oils, both the mixable oils, alkyd oils, and oil sticks, and which oils should I use. And then you can add mediums to your oils. Altersheen, the drying time. Now oils, the dries really, really shallow, so you can add stuff to it to make it dry faster. Thicken or thin the paint, varnish it. A lot of info about what it is. And then we have it's kind of an interview with Isabella Ruelofs, which are making Isaro oil paints, oil colors. So this is her, I guess. So and then they are teaching us a little bit about white, because obviously we all have seen that white isn't just white. White comes in different colors, really. Radiant white, titanium white, titanium zinc white, quick dry, fast matte, phthalic white, zinc white, warm white, cool white, titanium buff, which is a more Greyish. Yellow, greyish, white. And here they have tested them out, and we can learn about how they feel. And then some cold Vivax phenomenon and info about the Gaklid light. I have no idea what that is, but and there's the secrets in how they are making oil paint. So the pig mess oil, so we learn how they actually are making oil paint. And some info about the difference between professional oils and basic oil paint. And here we have this solvent guide going through a lot of different solvents that you can use with the oil paint. And this shows us what different things are, lots of different solvents and who make them, and some info about it, and if it's oil paint thinning or clean or brush, if it has a sense, if it's flammable and caution, and all kind of info about that. Then we move on to acrylic paint. What makes it so special? What's the difference between the different acrylic paint? Because they come in different ways too. And a little tip about which acrylic should I use, adding mediums, varnish it, how to varnish, and a little bit about acrylic pouring, which is kind of messy but amazing effect. I love the patterns in it. It's so much fun. Now I doesn't do this, but I have seen so many do it. And a little bit about acrylic gouache, or gouache, traditional gouache, artist gouache, the designer, and acrylic. And lots of info about that. And a watercolor guide. What makes a watercolor so special? What are the different what is the difference in between watercolor paint, watercolor paint sticks, watercolor pencils, watercolor markers, and watercolor ink? So you can learn a lot about what the different things are and how you use them. And also here about mediums that you can choose to add to it, what they do, what will help you. So this has a lot of info, which is very handy actually. And then we have a little something about the mineral pigments that you find in Daniel's myth Primatech watercolors. Now I don't have any of those, but I have seen videos of them and they look amazing. And a little something about the Isaro watercolors. And a review of the Isaro watercolors. And then we move on to pastels. What makes pastels so special? And then the difference between soft pastels, hard pastels, and pan and pastels. Again, a little bit, you can, and they even mention pastel pencils here. How you use them, making washes, blending, what tools, choosing the surface. And what do I need to work with pastels? A little bit info about this Jackson's homemade soft pastels, how they make it, and this unique midnight set of pastels that someone has made. And then we move on to difference between graphite and charcoal. Different types of pens and sticks, and how it's made, what to choose, and difference between charcoal kind of sticks and stuff and powder. Charcoal comes in powder as well, and pencils, of course. And then we have a look on erasers. Lots of different erasers for different things. We use kneaded erasers on watercolor paper, so we don't ruin the tooth of the paper, but lift the graphite up, kind of thing. And then you have all different erasers made of gum, plastic, electric erasers, and erasers that crumbs, and some that don't. Some tips about how to erase. Then we go over for something. This is acrylic erase and markers, because a Molotov one for all has made this set by spray cans and the markers that you can combine. Brushes, we all need that for different things. So a little bit about the head and the binding and the handle. Best selling for or different for oil and acrylics, what to look for in those. A watercolor brush guide, going through what do we look for in a brush for watercolors. And then we have this pocket brushes and how to take care of them so that they last us a long time. And then of course, when we have all these things, we need paper. So this is a paper guide, paper to use with pencils and charcoals, paper with soft pastels, paper for mixed media with oil and acrylic, printmaking, all sort of stuff. And of course, we have a whole page of itself just for watercolor paper, because the paper is quite important. Frame building, advertising, and here we have someone testing out this Stonehenge Aqua, hot press, watercolor paper. So we see what she has done there. And some info about the Yupo paper. Yupo is something I haven't tested out, but I have seen it, and it's kind of weird because it's kind of plasticky paper that you watercolor on, actually. So it makes it easy to lift. So this is a test on Yupo paper and original normal watercolor paper. So you can learn more about the Yupo paper there. And we have a guide to canvases, different types, linen, cotton, and jute, and some weight about them. Are you using the right surface? Some tools that you need to have them, and maybe the canvases, how to build or show something. Yeah, this is some studio stuff that you might need. This is a brush tab which you can clean your brushes in, and this is the same thing. We have some soap and some tools, and a little bit of carving wood cutting tools and carving, making pictures with that, and a little guide to palettes, oil and acrylic palettes, whether we should use wood, plastic paper, or glass, and a watercolor palette guide, because there are a lot to choose from. And then we have a little something about easels, why this kind of wood, and this is, we take a look at the Cappelletto easel. Looks good. And art material map, who shows us kind of what things are made of. We have the color pigment, and when you mix that with oil, you get oil bars, water mixable oil paint, print making, oil based inks, color, and you mix that with the polymer emulsion something, yeah, whatever. Then you make fluid acrylic paint, acrylic ink, acrylic printmaking inks, gouache, acrylics, and you mix color with alcohol. You make alcohol-based markers, paints, and pigment and gum. You may make watercolor sticks, watercolor paint, gouache, watercolor print making inks, color or pigment with clay or gum. You make pastel pencils, soft pencils, graphite. Yeah, you see in the wax. Then we get color pencils or all pencils have some wax and some oil. Whether a pencil is an oil-based pencil or not, just depends on how much oil it has. So a oil pencil has more oil than wax, and a wax-based pencil has more wax than oil. But all has both wax and oil. So a little bit about the competition that Jackson's just had, who won it, and a little bit about him, some of the category winners, and of course they have books and DVDs available, how to order, ordering information, and all of that. So this, let me see, very specialty catalogs available. They also have catalogs very teaching us more about oil, acrylic, watercolor, pastels catalog. So I'm getting one of those on my next order as well, because I find this really tutorial and informative without being big, heavy, hard stuff to learn. This is a short introduction catalog kind of thing. So I will link to Jackson Art under this video. So for the part, those of you who like this can go and pick it up. As I said, it doesn't cost you anything. It's very, at least it was. I don't know if they are going to change that, but for now, it's very. So that was it for me for now. So I hope that you all enjoyed this, and I will see you soon in my next video. Bye.